Well, hello guys, Liam Show TV here, and this time, as you can see, we're doing another LEGO Dimensions pack review. This time we've got a level pack. This is 71204, ages 7 to 14 with 83 pieces. This is the Doctor Who level pack. That's right, Doctor Who. And so, this is a little bit different of a pack than I've normally been reviewing. But this, as you can see, it says all new game level and adventure through space and time. It includes the TARDIS, the 12th Doctor, which I've been told is excellent, and K-9. And then, of course, this is part of the BBC series that comes on Doctor Who. And so there you can see the front of the box. Then you can see the back of the box there. You can see it has 31 features. And this time, since it has two builds, not counting the minifigure, it has the TARDIS rebuilds and the K-9 rebuilds. And then we got the classic in language, and then Batman, Wildstyle, and Gandalf. And then the set number and like logo being one. So And then there's a little picture of what it unlocks there at the bottom. I am now going to build this and let's take a look. Here is everything you get in the Doctor Who LEGO Dimensions level pack. And we'll start off with taking a look at the instructions, first of all. And here they are. As you see, this thing is the front of the box there. And we go straight in. Just building the 12th Doctor there, as you can see. And, Then you've got to place him on how to place him on the toy pad and building instructions using the game. Except I do it differently. I go and look up something. Go look up the instructions on the internet. And I'll link to the instructions I got off of where I got them in the description below. But there, you see that? Then we have the packs here. This is a Wave 2 pack, of course. So it's gonna look a little bit different. We get the fun packs here. We got Wonder Woman, Cyborg, Bart Simpson, Emmett, Badcock, Benny, Jay, Samurai X, Mia, Zane, Gollum, Legolas, Gimli. I have reviewed the following: Cyborg, Badcock, and Zane there. And I also have reviewed Cragger, Laval, and Eris. And I will also be picking sometime in the future the other packs. Let's see where the team packs and level packs are. Okay, so here they are. Got the level packs first this time. We got Back to the Future, which I'll be getting sometime. I don't know if I'm going to be getting the Simpsons one. Portal I probably will be getting, and I'm reviewing Doctor Who right now. We've got the team packs for Wave 2. This is Wave 1, of course, but Wave 2 is Ninjago, and we'll be getting those probably when I go to Toys R Us. You got the Jurassic World, Scooby-Doo, Ninjago for the team packs, and then that's basically it. And then we have the Beast Count and the went with a little city thing. That is a different layout for the instruction book than we are normally linked to, which is kind of good for the back. Change it from a little bit. But now let's take a look at the actual set. Here is the actual set. And three things included here, because it is a LEGO Dimension level pack, is from left to right, we have the TARDIS, the 12th Doctor, and K-9. Now I want you to have in mind that I only know this little bit about Doctor Who here. I just like this set because it looks so cool and appealing to me, and I know what Doctor Who is, but not exactly that familiar with the show. But anyway, we'll take a look at the Doctor first. And here's the Doctor. Now I'm just going to keep you in mind, I am American, and I don't really watch Doctor Who all the time, so don't get into it that much. But I do know this guy is referred to the 12th Doctor. I honestly like this character that I watched sometime long ago. I don't know his name, so you probably will know what I'm talking about. But this guy looks amazing. I think he's the one that comes in the official Doctor Who Lego set that from Lego Ideas. But you can see he is torso detailing and leg detailing and facial detailing. Pick him up the toy pad here for a second. And then the little bit of back torso detailing. And his hair is just cool. And no back torso or head detailing. He did it. Does have a screwdriver, sonic screwdriver, which is a pretty cool mold, I have to say here. And yeah, this come with two in this set, so if you lose one, you got an extra one. But it is a pretty cool new little mold there, and I'm glad Lego actually put it in there. And they get two of them, it's pretty cool. Yeah, that's the Doctor there. And on to the toy pad, little toy tag here. As you all know, same old thing. Put the Doctor Who one would only recognize, of course, Doctor Who himself, the 12th Doctor. That comes in the set because the data stored inside of the tag, game tag, is the only... It's for this minifigure specifically. And I hope they do come out with more Dimension Doctor Who sets. I know they're coming out with Ghostbusters, which I probably will be getting because Ghostbusters is pretty cool. Yeah, it's pretty cool. And it only recognizes that tag, so if you put any other minifigure on it, it will not recognize it. It would probably break the game. I don't know, but I won't be playing it, so, and I wouldn't even try it. But you can see the printing on there is blue and red, just like his torso detailing, leg detailing, and all around there. It's pretty cool. There, I like that. And yeah, that's it about for the 12th Doctor. Let's get on to the other parts. Here is the little TARDIS build. Now this is probably one of my favorites of this build, this whole set, because it's just an iconic thing. A alien, or whatever you call him, that rides inside of a British police box that can travel through time and space. That's pretty cool. Yeah. You can see that all four of the little panels on the side there are printed. And it actually does look like a rocket. The second one on the box actually, or second or third one actually looks like a rocket there. It actually looks like it. But it looks just like a rocket when you have it on the little stand there. I'm not going to bother to sit there and show you the stand because it's the same thing. It only you can, instead of having a minifigure, you can put any of them on the regular size stands that doesn't have printing on it, I believe. And it would mess it up. And that's pretty cool. And yeah, they got that there. They got a little stand, basic stand to stand the TARDIS on when it's off of the thing. You can see that there. 3D view of it. 3D view of the TARDIS. Just like that. Little thingy at the top. And then you get the base. I don't think that comes off because it would just break it. But yeah, it's pretty cool. And I had to say that's pretty epic. And yeah, that's it for the TARDIS. Now let's get on to K9. Here is K9. And he's pretty cool. And literally it's not spelled how you would really think it would be. It's literally spelled K little line dot nine. I really don't know much about this guy. Like I said, I don't watch Doctor Who. I just liked it because this set kind of appealed to me because I had watched it like once or twice in my whole life. And I know that it's a pretty cool show. My dad said it's been around for a long time. It's on BBC, which is British Broadcast Channel. And from time to time I will search the channel and find it on there, but you know, it's pretty cool. Anyway, moving on. Got some pretty cool printed pieces there. Like I said, no stickers. And nice printed there. Nice print from Star Wars there. K9 there. And nice overall little build. What they had to work with was such a small scale of pieces. And you used all the other pieces to build the other forms of the set. I won't be doing that, of course. But I only did that for a few of them. But, yeah. So, just a good look at that one more time. Nice little robot dog. But, yeah. That about completes it for the Doctor Who double pack. And, yeah. Now on to my thoughts and commentary for this set. On to my thoughts and commentary. I really do like this set. I, once again, am an American, so I don't watch Doctor Who. I barely know what it's about. I know it's a time-traveling alien doctor person who can walk into a, who has a police box, a British police box that controls the time. That's really all I know, and there's like 13 different ones. And so please don't criticize me for not knowing much about it. This set, it appealed to me. It's just an iconic type of thing. Yeah, I am going to rate this set. I'm going to rate it a 10. Because, yeah, there's not really anything wrong with it. The only thing really are the fact that I'm barely know anything about Doctor Who in the first place. I just know it's a very famous British show. And, yeah, very cool. And for people who like that, who like the show, they will definitely need to pick this up and add it to the collection. And I really do think that I would like to get the other set coming from it because it looks so cool. The TARDIS looks so cool in the set. And it's so much bigger, and this one looks iconic, or exactly like the one in the show, I believe. Yeah, I would have liked seeing a Dalek in this set. Something else I would like I knew about. I can kind of say the voice Exterminate. That's the best starter pool you can come up with. But not that bad. But rating to this day is going to be a 10. But other than that, I really don't know much about Doctor Who. You can tell me if you want to in the comments below something about it. I'm not gonna go watch 12 seasons of it. Because I'm not that crazy about it in the first place. This set does cost $30 as well. In the store because it is a Wave 2 set and I don't think it's an exclusive anywhere. So, that's all I have to say for this review. So please comment, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye.